Crime Junkie is one of the biggest podcasts in the world. Smartless? Massive. Call Her Daddy? Huge. The best podcast in the world? Okay, well, that one's discontinued. We all know these podcasts have giant audiences, but does anyone have the actual figures? Listener numbers have historically been one of podcasting's biggest mysteries. But if you're booking guest interviews or ad spots, this is need-to-know information. Fortunately, I've got five ways you can gauge the size of a podcast audience. First, let's get one thing straight. Only the podcast publisher has access to their complete listener data. So if you're desperate for fully accurate stats for a show that isn't yours, you're gonna need to reach out and ask. Now that that's settled, let's start with the most efficient method, using Rephonic. We've built an AI-powered algorithm that estimates listener numbers for over 2.5 million podcasts and makes them available in our database. While these numbers are technically best guess, they're based on hundreds of publicly available data points and give you a really solid idea if a show is worth pitching or not. Just head to the key facts section on any podcast page and you'll see estimated listeners per episode, monthly listens, and Spotify follower numbers. I've included a link to the free trial in the description if you want to try it out. Okay, so the second approach is to check the number of ratings and reviews across different platforms. You'll want to prioritize Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and the other big platforms. But the problem with this approach is that there's not always a direct link between the volume of listener feedback and audience size. And you know, Rephonic actually collects all this feedback data and makes it available for free to help you save time. Third, you could check the chart rankings, because if a show is ranking highly, it's an indication that they have a pretty sizable audience. And again, it's not an ideal measure of popularity though. It's thought that chart rankings are calculated by looking at the number of new followers each podcast has added over a recent time window. So it's very possible for a show with relatively small listenership to rank highly in the charts. Also, if a show's audience tends to listen on a platform other than Spotify or Apple Podcasts, then naturally it just won't perform so well in those charts. In the US and the UK, these platforms are very dominant podcast players. But if the show you're researching targets listeners in other countries, it's really something to think about a bit more. Okay, fourth, you could look at the stats revealed by some podcast apps. Now, this requires a bit more detective work, but it can be very helpful if you've got more time on your hands. I mentioned Spotify follower numbers earlier, but you can't actually see them on the Spotify app itself. Your best bet is to go to Rephonic for that. But for example, you could check the number of subscribers on CastBox to get a feel for a show's size. It's important to note that CastBox only accounts for a very small proportion of podcast listeners, around 2%. So you could try to extrapolate that data to get a fuller picture. The fifth and final method is checking the show's social media presence, which is pretty straightforward. Of course, you'll want to check follower numbers on different platforms, but also the number of likes and the engagement rate. Logically, the higher the number of followers and likes, the bigger the show likely is. Also, don't forget that more and more people are listening to podcasts just on YouTube. So the show you're researching may publish episodes there as well, and in which case it's definitely worth checking out how many views they typically get. You can just do this with a quick search on YouTube, or you can use Rephonic to see the link YouTube account and total number of views. And there you have it. Those are the five best ways to gauge the size of a podcast audience. And like I mentioned before, if you want fully accurate numbers, you'll need to go straight to the source. But if not, one of these methods should really serve the purpose. Don't forget to subscribe for tips on how to run more effective podcast guesting campaigns.